Blood pressure is an important measure of overall health, so it is important to understand the meaning behind the two numbers that make up a blood pressure reading. In this video, we will break down the significance of systolic and diastolic blood pressure readings and explain which of the two numbers are important. We will also discuss how to interpret these numbers and tips for maintaining healthy blood pressure. By the end of this video, you should have a better understanding of blood pressure readings and the role that systolic and diastolic numbers play in your health. Just a quick reminder, information contained in this video is for educational purposes only, and shall not be used as a substitute for medical advice, diagnosis, or treatment. With that said, let's jump in. Blood pressure is a vital indicator of our overall health and well-being. It measures the force of blood against the walls of our arteries as it circulates through our bodies. The results are recorded as two numbers, such as 120/80 mmHg. The top number represents systolic blood pressure, which is the pressure in our arteries when the heart beats and pumps blood. The bottom number represents diastolic blood pressure, which is the pressure in our arteries when the heart is at rest between beats. Blood pressure readings are essential in assessing our cardiovascular health. They provide valuable insights into how efficiently our heart is working and the condition of our arteries. However, it is important to note that while both systolic and diastolic readings are significant, they serve different purposes. Systolic blood pressure reflects the force exerted on artery walls when the heart contracts and pumps blood throughout the body. It is considered a crucial indicator of overall cardiovascular health and is often given more attention by healthcare professionals. Diastolic blood pressure, on the other hand, represents the pressure in our arteries when the heart is at rest. It is an essential measure of the health of our blood vessels, as it determines how well they relax and expand between heartbeats. It's important to know how to react when either number is out of range. So let's first talk about what doctors historically thought about blood pressure readings. In the past, medical professionals gave greater significance to diastolic blood pressure. The prevailing notion was that systolic blood pressure typically rises as a person gets older, causing the higher number to be disregarded unless it deviated significantly from the normal range. Conversely, even a minor deviation in diastolic blood pressure warranted medicinal intervention. This perspective was grounded in the belief that the resting heart's baseline pressure played a pivotal role in gauging overall cardiac health. However, a number of recent studies have presented contrasting findings. Let's now look at the risk of having high systolic blood pressure number. High systolic blood pressure poses several serious health risks. When left uncontrolled, it can significantly increase the chances of developing heart disease, stroke, and other severe conditions. The elevated pressure against the walls of your arteries puts strain on your heart and blood vessels, leading to long-term damage. One of the most concerning risks associated with high systolic blood pressure is the development of cardiovascular diseases. When the heart has to work harder to pump blood, it can become weakened over time, leading to conditions such as heart failure or an enlarged heart. Additionally, the constant high pressure can cause damage to the arteries, increasing the risk of atherosclerosis and potentially resulting in heart attacks or strokes. High systolic blood pressure also contributes to kidney damage. The kidneys play a crucial role in filtering waste from the blood, and increased pressure can impair their function. Over time, this can lead to kidney disease or even kidney failure. Furthermore, untreated high systolic blood pressure can cause damage to the eyes, leading to vision problems or even blindness. It can also affect cognitive function, increasing the risk of dementia or cognitive decline. Given the significant health risks associated with high systolic blood pressure, it is crucial to address and manage this condition. Now let's look at the risk of having high diastolic blood pressure. Having an increased diastolic pressure might lead to the weakening of the primary artery in your body, which is referred to as the aorta. This artery has a central path from your heart through your abdomen, and then it divides into separate arteries that extend into your legs. If a segment of the aorta in the abdominal region becomes weaker, it could develop into a bulging area. This bulge occurs due to the excessive stretching of the aorta in the abdominal region. Prolonged high diastolic pressure could potentially result in the rupture of this bulge, leading to severe internal bleeding that has the potential to be fatal. The medical term used to describe this life-threatening condition is abdominal aortic aneurysm. So which is more important? Both numbers are equally important. While many people may focus solely on the systolic reading, which is the top number, both readings provide valuable information about your overall cardiovascular health. For instance, a high systolic reading may indicate that your heart is working harder than it should be, potentially putting you at risk for heart disease or stroke. On the other hand, a high diastolic reading may indicate that your arteries are stiff and not relaxing properly between beats, which can also be a sign of underlying health issues. Additionally, tracking both readings over time can provide a more comprehensive picture of your overall cardiovascular health and can help identify any trends or changes that may require further attention. This is especially important for individuals with conditions such as hypertension or prehypertension. Finally, let's look at tips for maintaining healthy blood pressure. Maintaining healthy blood pressure is crucial for overall cardiovascular health and reducing the risk of heart disease and stroke. While there are various factors that can contribute to high blood pressure, such as genetics and age, making lifestyle changes can significantly improve and maintain healthy blood pressure levels. Here are some tips to help you maintain a healthy blood pressure. Number 1, limiting salt intake. Limiting salt intake is an important part of maintaining healthy blood pressure. Salt can have negative effects on blood pressure levels, so it's crucial to be mindful of your consumption. Salt, which is commonly found in processed and packaged foods, can cause the body to retain water, leading to increased blood volume and higher blood pressure. To limit your salt intake, try to avoid processed foods and opt for fresh, whole foods instead. Number 2, monitoring your blood pressure regularly. Monitoring your blood pressure regularly is an essential step in maintaining healthy blood pressure levels. By regularly checking your blood pressure, you can track any changes or fluctuations and take appropriate action to keep it within a healthy range. It also allows you to assess the effectiveness of any lifestyle changes or medications you may be implementing. Number 3, a balanced and nutritious diet. Maintaining a balanced and nutritious diet is essential for keeping your blood pressure in check. A healthy diet can help lower your blood pressure and reduce the risk of developing heart disease and other related conditions. So, what exactly does a balanced and nutritious diet look like? It starts with incorporating plenty of fruits and vegetables into your meals. These colorful and flavorful foods are packed with essential vitamins, minerals, and antioxidants that promote overall health. Aim to fill half of your plate with fruits and vegetables at every meal. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, like, comment and subscribe, and click on the bell icon so you never miss a video. We wish you all the best for your health and well-being.